Good afternoon from the arena in San Juan. Studio 23 presents our coverage of your Sunday doubleheader in the volleyball tournament of season 74 of the UAAP. The Lady Tamaraws of Far Eastern University looking to go solo third as if they win today at 7-4 as they take on the winless Lady Maroons of University of the Philippines, while in our second game today, the Tigresses of USD also looking to go third with a win today at 7-4 as they take on the defending champions, undefeated at 10-0, the Lady Spikers of De La Salle University. Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to Studio 23. This is brought to you by ABS-CBN Sports. I'm Eric Tipan alongside Anne Remulla.
Hi, Eric. Of course, another important afternoon for the teams that we have today.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at the team standings after the wins yesterday by UE and also by Ateneo.
That's right. Well, prior to this, actually, before we got to the standings that you see on your screens, it was actually a three-way tie between FEU, USD, and Adamson. But Adamson, after falling against Ateneo, now is currently ranked number 5, while we have here FEU and USD currently tied at 6-4. So today is actually very important for FEU. They should win this game against UP so that they can secure a solo third. Well, at least that's what we will see after this game, ano? Because after this, we'll see USD and DLSU fight against each other.
So that's how important it's going to be for Far Eastern University and this win that they need to get so as not to fall behind in this race for the top three of the final four, or make that the bottom three part of the final four, because obviously the one and two belongs to right now in a very solid fashion, La Salle and Ateneo. While for UP, obviously, you know, they're out of the hunt for a final four position, but definitely every game is a must-win game so as to, you know, move forward to season 75 with a little bit of pride.
That's right. So all of the games that UP has at this point, really, they're playing for pride. The last thing that they want, of course, is to exit season 74 without the win.
All right, let's revisit the last meeting between these two teams. Obviously, that was the first round of eliminations. FEU with a solid performance against UP.
It was a straight set win for FEU, a very impressive game we've seen from these young girls in the FEU squad. Of course, in that game, they won, like what I said, straight sets, and it was a rather easy win for the girls. Talagang they were able to control the pace of the match. As you take a look at what had happened in that game, straight set match score was 25-17, 25-10, and 25-16. And in terms of how the Lady Tamaraws actually won that game, you'll see the disparity in terms of the points scored when it came to attacks, 44 compared to only 12 of the Lady Maroons. They also had better blocking, 5-2 versus the Lady Maroons. And look at this, 12 service aces. So clearly in that last game, the Lady Maroons had difficulties in receiving. And on top of that, they also had more errors, 26 for the Lady Maroons compared to only 14 of the Lady Tamaraws.
Lady Tamaraws clearly playing better and better with each and every game of season 74 of the UAAP. And that is even with, you know, sustaining their intensity despite losing, you know, Micah Morada during the middle of the season, as she already, you know, shifted careers. And they've found offense from other girls. And let's take a look at the last match they had. That was, you know, they were definitely the underdogs in this match against the Tigresses, who were playing better as well after struggling at the early part of the season.
It's a team as a surprise to a lot of people. You know how these girls have really matured in a short span of time. They've challenged one of the toughest teams that we have here in the in this season, which is USD. And there, you can see it in sinasabi mo, no? FEU winning over the Lady Tigresses. And here, makikita natin, dikit na dikit yung laban. And, you know, the Lady Tamaraws really gave USD a big challenge on that day. And even when it came to, you know, the skills, looking at it, talagang nakasabay itong Lady Tamaraws. 50 attack points compared to 52 of USD sa blocking, dikit din at 7-6. And when it came to the services, they really focused, no? And scored 9 service aces. Same with USD scoring 7. And ito rin, I think, no, the reason why USD fell on that day was because of the number of errors that they committed.
Now, in case you guys noticed, in the first set against USD, FEU lost. So it's a come-from-behind win for them. Let's see the mindset of this team coming into today's game and how, you know, how they will start off strong even against a team that's struggling. Obviously, you don't want to be lax and complacent, even against one of the struggling teams in the UAAP. We picked the mind of the fifth best receiver in the league. That's Christine Agno, as she earlier spoke to our Jazz Reyes.
So, Christine, maganda na laro natin in the last game. What do you think na nag-contribute dun sa panalo natin over UST?
Yun nga po. Kailangan ako yung unang mag-iingay dun sa loob para mabus yung moral nung bawat isa sa amin. Tapos, every mga nag-error, kailangan kausapin agad para mabuhayan ng loob sa kawag madaw.
Okay, aside from that, today we're beating UP. So, what do you think na kailangan natin gawin para manalo naman tayo over UP?
Ganun pa rin po, wag mag-relax, tsaka wag i-underestimate yung opponent, tsaka kailangan kung ano lang yung laro namin, yun lang yung lalaruin namin, tsaka enjoy lang palagi sa court, tsaka communication.
Thank you, Christine. That was Christine Agno of the FEU Lady Tamaraw.
Obviously, the focus is not to get rattled and to keep playing your game. How important are those two things, and especially for a team like FEU, going up against a team that they feel, they know, and everybody thinks they can beat? But, you know, how do you keep your composure and not feel like you've got this game already, even before you played 1 point?
Well, that's right. I think for FEU, you know, what they are looking at this point really is to keep that focus. And one thing she mentioned also was for them to enjoy the game, because we know we've seen a lot of teams who we know can do very well, pero pag na-pressure at na-tense, mm-hmm, all of a sudden their game really changes. So it's very important that even if FEU is going up against a winless team like UP, they continue to keep themselves focused.
All right, let's cross the net and talk about the Lady Maroons of the University of the Philippines, a team that has struggled the entire season so far at 0-10, looking for their first win this season. And it has really been such, you know, so much difficulty with each and every game. They've been, several times they've been blown out, and in this last one, it was no different for the UP Lady Maroons.
Well, it was clearly a struggle in that game. As you take a look at the score, the USU really clearly dominated that match, 25-15 for all three sets. And if you look at the stats again in terms of the skills, you'll see the disparity with the numbers, 45 attack points, only 25 for the Lady Maroons. Although they were able to keep it at par with blocking, you'll see here again that the problem remains to be service reception, where UST scored 12 service aces in that match. So I think for the Lady Maroons, it has been a struggle this season, but coming into today's game, they should just look at it on the bright side. They have nothing to lose. All they need to do is to just play their best.
They've got a new system, a new coach in Jaro Tomalde, but they're still seeking their first win this season and have really, like what Ann said, have really struggled. One of their veterans, one of the best servers in the league, fifth best server in the league so far this season, Southlyn Ramos, earlier spoke to our Victor Lopez.
South, obviously, you guys have lost 10 games in a row. You know, what are your observations in regards to that? How will you guys finally pull out one win?
Sa tingin ko, yung kailangan lang namin gawin is yung parang dapat pare-pareho kami ng mindset, as in from the start of the game hanggang sa end. Siguro kung gagawin namin yun, parang magiging united yung pag-iisip namin sa loob ng court. So mas maganda yung kakalabasan ng games namin.
Alright, thank you very much. That was Southlyn Ramos of the UP Lady Maroons.
It's going to be an uphill climb for Southlyn Ramos and the Lady Maroons, but they've got to find a way. They've got to push themselves, and it has to start today.
That's right. And it can't be just one person stepping up for the team. What they need right now is teamwork. Everybody has to really step up and contribute.
Coach Ness Familar of the Lady Tamaraw is looking to push them to 7-4 at solo third, while on the other side, consultant Vic Isada is back on the bench alongside head coach Jaro Tubalde. Let's see what inputs he can make to give the Lady Maroons their first win of the season. The first set coming up right after these.